You know, I don't feel a work is complete until a viewer sees it, and then it's completed, and hopefully it touches someone. Some pictures will touch someone. That's my hope.
Would you say, if you had to choose to pick some of the most thrilling experience meeting some of them?
I have to say Muhammad Ali. He was really the bravest man, and when I met him and photographed him, he was so humble and so kind. He wanted to sign, he wanted everyone to, I'll sign everything. He wanted to be in every picture, you know, because we have a rule in my studio, no pictures and things like that. And he said, no, I want to do this. And I was like, really? Because he had Parkinson's disease at the time. And it was incredible. I love sex. I think that the human body is beautiful. And I think that sex is a gift from God. So I've really tried to take the human form and reclaim it, rescue it from commodification and pornography, and say that, you know, it's more than that. It's more than just a object of sexual gratification. It's the housing for the soul. 30-year career, 30 years of making pictures, you know, we have different reasons. Each picture has different reasons. Sometimes it's just to laugh, and sometimes it's light, and sometimes there's deeper. And as I got older, they were getting more, you know, changing with me.
Warhol, what did he mean to you? Was your sort of a mentor to you?
Well, he was my first boss, and I was always a big fan when I was a very small boy. When I came to New York and had learned photography, you know, I would see Andy out all the time. But when I brought him my photograph, that's when I first talked to him. And I went up into a club and I said, "Hey, you know, I'm a photographer. I'd like to work for interview," and was amazing, from 84 to 87 until he died. Just generous. He told me, do whatever you want, just make everyone look good. That was his advice to me.
Which you accomplished.
I tried to.